إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. The brothers that are in the back, if they can come forward inshallah ta'ala and fill these gaps in, so the people who come in can find space at the back inshallah ta'ala. So those who are at the back, can you come forward bi-idhnillahi al-kareem inshallah ta'ala, come forward, barakallahu feekum. And those move forward inshallah ta'ala, fill the gaps bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. موضوعنا إن شاء الله تعالى, the topic that we will be speaking about today بإذن الله الكريم is couple of days ago, you're all aware or you should be aware إن شاء الله تعالى that a great noble scholar, a scholar of our time, a man of the Sunnah, had died in the land of Yemen. الشيخ عبد الرحمن مرعي العدني رحمه الله رحمة واسعة. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow His mercy on him. He was unjustly killed. Those who have killed him have been caught. So inshallah ta'ala, our khutbah is to speak about this topic as hajatul ummah, the need that the ummah have ila al-ulama, to the scholars. And those who have killed him unjustly, dhulman wa udwana, where would they go in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the day of judgment? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَكْفُرُونَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ, those who disbelieve in the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَيَقْتُلُونَ النَّبِيِّينَ بِغَيْرِ حَقٍّ, and they kill the prophets unjustly, وَيَقْتُلُونَ الَّذِينَ يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْقِسْطِ مِنَ النَّاسِ, and they also kill those who call to justice, those who call to the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they kill them. Allah says, فَبَشِّرْهُمْ بِعَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ, give those people a glad tidings of a severe punishment of the hellfire. Who do they kill? They kill the prophets, and they kill those who call to good, those who warn the people from destruction, deviation, shirk, bid'ah, and sins, they kill them. Give glad tidings to those people, فَبَشِّرْهُمْ بِعَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ حَبِطَتْ أَعْمَالُهُمْ, those people, their actions have been nullified. في الدنيا, in this world, والآخرة, and in the hereafter. وما لهم من ناصرين, and they have no one giving them victory. So killing an innocent Muslim itself, it has a big, serious place in our religion. How about if a person kills an alim من علماء السنة? الإمام ابن رجب الحنبلي رحمه الله, he has a little رسالة where he called it Warathatul Anbiya, where he explains the hadith of Abu Darda in Musnad Imam Ahmad. Very small book that a person can read in a couple of hours. Ibn Rajab rahimahullah, he comments on this ayah, and he says, وَلِهَذَا الْمَعْنَى كَانَ أَشَدُّ النَّاسِ عَذَابًا, the people who have the severest punishment, I'm from the people who have the severest punishment the day of judgment, is مَنْ قَتَلَ نَبِيًّا, the one who kills a prophet. Why? لأنه سعى في الأرض بالفساد, because that person has strived on this earth to bring corruption to this earth. What he's working towards is corruption. ومن قتل عالما, and anyone who kills a scholar, who is what? The scholar is a خليفة النبي. He has taken the place of the prophet. He has inherited the prophet. This ummah is not like the previous nations. Because the previous nations, كُلَّمَا مَاتَ نَبِيٌ, every time a prophet died, Allah would bring them another prophet. As for this ummah, the ones who have taken the places of the prophets are the ulama, the scholars, the people of knowledge. So you've killed the people who have inherited the prophet. The Shaykh went on to saying, وَلِهَذَا قَرَنَ اللَّهُ بَيْنَ قَتْلِ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ وَقَتْلِ الْعُلَمَاءِ الْآمِرِينَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ فِي قَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى وَيَقْتُلُونَ الَّذِينَ يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْقِسْطِ مِنَ النَّاسِ فَبَشِّرْهُمْ بِعَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. Allah, He mentions the scholars right next to the prophets when it comes to killing them, because they are the ones who are standing in the places of the prophets. إخواني, فقد العالم, losing one scholar is a musiba. It's a affliction Allah has afflicted a nation with, if they lose a scholar, and if they lose a person of knowledge. وَهِيَ رَاذَا, it is مِنْ أَعْظَمِ الْمَصَائِبِ, rather it is from the greatest afflictions that a nation can go through. Our Salaf, our pious predecessors, they realized that, and they knew that it was serious, they lose a scholar. Al-Imam al-Hasan al-Basri rahimahullah, he said, مَوْتُ الْعَالِمِ, the death of a scholar is a thalma, it's a problem. It's a place no one can fulfill. His absence, it's an empty space that no one is able to fulfill, unless a person of knowledge, of course, comes and takes that place. فِي الْإِسْلَامِ لَا يَسُدُّهَا شَيْءٌ مَخْتَلَفَ اللَّيْلُ وَالنَّهَارِ, nothing can take that place. If you and I die today, there are probably many better than us and greater than us that are going to come. But when a scholar passes away and he goes, that place is empty, and that gives the freedom of shaitan to exercise his misguidance to the people. Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyyah rahimahullah, he has a book called Miftahu Dar al-Sa'adah. Ibn al-Qayyim says, لَمَّا كَانَ صَلَاحُ الْوُجُودِ بِالْعُلَمَاء, when it became the existence of this people, its righteousness is connected to the scholars. For us to be prosperous and good and righteous, it's connected to the scholars. وَلَوْلَاهُمْ, and if it wasn't for the scholars, كَانَ النَّاسُ كَالْبَهَائِمِ, the people will be like the cattle, the animals. بَلْ أَسْوَأُ حَالًا, rather we may even be worse than the animal. We may even be worse than the animal. Also, Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said in his same book, Miftahu Dar al-Sa'adah, he said, أَمَّا الْعُلَمَاءِ بِاللَّهِ, as for the scholars who know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala الشرائع, the legislations that He has passed. وَأَمْرِهِ, and they know the commands that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given. فَهُمْ حَيَاتُ الْوُجُودِ, they are the life of our existence. وَرُوحُهُ وَلَا يُسْتَغْنَى عَنْهُمْ طَرْفَةَ عَيْنٍ, and we can't live without them even a split second. We can't exist without them. Abdullah ibn Abbas, when it came to the ayah, أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّا نَأْتِي الْأَرْضَ نَنْقُصُهَا مِنْ أَطْرَافِهَا, Allah says, do they not see that we will reduce from the earth, we will take from it? Abdullah ibn Abbas said in this ayah, he commented in some of the riwayat that was brought from him, Ibn Abbas said, خَرَابُهَا بِمَوْتِ عُلَمَائِهَا وَفُقَهَائِهَا وَأَهْلِ الْخَيْرِ مِنْهَا, the destruction that comes to this earth, it means the death of the scholars and the jurists and the fuqaha and the righteous people amongst them. And also Mujahid ibn Jabr, who Sufyan al-Thawri said, إِذَا جَاءَكَ تَفْسِيرُ مُجَاهِدْ فَحَسْبُكَ بِهِ, if the tafsir of Mujahid comes to you, that is enough. Mujahid said that the ayah is referring to مَوْتُ الْعُلَمَاءِ, the death of the scholars, and the scholars coming to an end. Hilal ibn Khabbab, he said, I came to my teacher Sa'id ibn Jubayr. Sa'id ibn Jubayr was a student of Abdullah ibn Abbas. He said, I came to him and I said to him, سألت ibn Jubayr. I asked Sa'id ibn Jubayr. Sa'id ibn Jubayr is the student of Abdullah ibn Abbas. He said to him, يا أبا عبد الله, ما علامة هلاك الناس, what is the sign that the people are going to be destroyed? And then he said, إِذَا هَلَكَ عُلَمَاؤُهُمْ, if their scholars die. If their scholars die, that is when the destruction will come to a nation. So a destruction of a nation is connected to what? The leaving and the absence of the scholars. ولذلك a poet, he said, الأرض تحيا إذا ما عاش عالمها متى يموت عالم مات منها يموت طرفه كالأرض تحيا إذا ما الغيث حل بها وإن أبى عاد في أكنافها التلف. Which is that which he took from the line, the ayah, أولم يروا أنا نأتي الأرض ننقصها من أطرافها. Imam Ahmad said, الناس محتاجون. The people are in need إلى العلم to knowledge. أكثر من حاجتهم, more than they are in need of إلى الطعام والشراب, more than they need food and drink. The people need knowledge more than they need food and drink. Why? لأن الطعام والشراب, because food and drink يحتاج إليه في اليوم مرة. The person may need to drink and to eat food maybe once a day, twice, three times, أو مرتين or twice. والعالم, as for the scholar, يحتاج إليه بعدد الأنفاس. As for the scholars, the person needs that scholar as many times as he breathes. الإمام الأجري رحمه الله, I think he described the need of the scholars heavily, greatly, mashallah. He said, فما ظنكم رحمكم الله بطريق فيه آفات كثيرة. He said, what do you think? A path that has a lot of thorns and it has ditches and harmful things are on the road. ويحتاج الناس إلى سلوكي في ليلة الظلماء. And the people, they need to go on this road at night. They have to. فإن لم يكن فيه مصابيح, if they don't have a candle, a light, something to shine. وإلا تحيروا, the people will be confused. They won't know what direction to go. فقيض الله لهم فيه مصابيح تضيء لهم. And Allah then makes for them and gives them a candle or a light, something in which they can use in that dark path at night. So they got it. فسلكوا على السلامة, and they treaded on that path with ease and peace, because they could see everything. ثم جاء الطبقات, and another people wanted to come. لا بد لهم من سلوك فيه, and they also want to take that path. فسلكوا, they also took that path. فبينما هم كذلك, but whilst those second group that came were taking the path and they were on the path, إذ طفئت المصابيح, the light was taken away from them. فبقوا في الظلمة, and they remained in the darkness. فما ظنكم بهم, what do you think of those people? What do you think those people are going to go through if the light is taken from them and it's pitch dark? هكذا العلماء, that's the scholars. في الناس, in the people. لا يعلم كثير من الناس, a lot of the people don't know. كيف أداء الفرائض, how to do the obligatory acts, they don't know. وكيف اجتناب المحارم, and how to stay away from the prohibited things. ولا كيف يعبد الله, and how Allah is worshipped في جميع ما يعبده به خلقه. They don't also know how to worship Allah in many of the things that the people should worship Allah with. Except through who? إلا ببقاء العلماء, except with the scholars to remain with them. فإذا مات العلماء, if the scholars die, تحير الناس, the people become confused. ودرس العلم, and knowledge will perish, brothers. بموتهم, due to their deaths. وظهر الجهل, ignorance will prevail and it will show. فإنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون مصيبة ما أعظمها على المسلمين. It is a great musibah that afflicts a nation and a people. Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah and Imam al-Muslim, both of them narrated on the authority of Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma. Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَقْبِضُ الْعِلْمَ انْتِزَاعًا يَنْتَزِعُهُ مِنْ سُدُورِ الرِّجَالِ وَلَكِنْ يَقْبِضُ الْعِلْمَ بِقَضِّ الْعُلَمَاءِ حَتَّى إِذَا لَمْ يَبْقَ عَالِمًا. Allah does not take knowledge from the people. He doesn't take it away from them. But he takes them by taking the scholars until there is no scholar left. اتخذ الناس, the people, they start to take رؤوسا جهالا. They start to take leaders who are ignorant. They see them as their mufti and their scholars. And they refer to those people as their علماء and their people of knowledge. فسئلوا فأفتوا بغير علم فضلوا وأضلوا. And so then those ignorant ones, because they think they've been made leaders, they give fatwa and they answer questions. So they misguide themselves and they misguide those who are around them. Al-Imam Abu Bakr, Muhammad ibn al-Walid al-Tartushi rahimahullah, he has a book called Al-Hawadith wal-Bid'ah. In that book, he commented on this particular hadith and he brought a benefit out of it, which I'm going to read on you inshallah ta'ala. He said, فَتَدَبَّرْ هَذَا الْحَدِيثَ ponder on this hadith. فإنه يدل this hadith indicates على أنه لا يؤتى الناس قط من قبل علمائهم. This hadith, ponder on it. Look at it and analyze it. Why? Because this hadith indicates that the people, a problem will not come to them through their scholars. We're not afflicted problems and suffering and misguidance doesn't come to us from the scholars. Hey, who is it? وَإِنَّمَا يُؤْتَوْنَا But rather it comes to them. مِنْ قِبَلِ أَنَّهُ إِذَا مَاتَ عُلَمَاءُمْ But the problem comes to them when their scholars die. أَفْتَى مَنْ لَيْسَ بِعَالِمٍ A fatwa is then given by a person who is not a scholar. فَيُؤْتَى النَّاسُ مِنْ قِبَلِهِ And then the problem comes to them from this individual. وَقَدْ صَرَّفَ عُمَرُ هَذَا And he said, Umar, he done tasrif of this issue, tasrifan faqal, مَا خَانَ أَمِينٌ قَطٌ وَلَكِنَّهُ تُمِنَ غَيْرُ أَمِينٍ فَخَانَ Umar رضي الله عنه, he said, that a trustworthy one does not deceive. But the one who deceived was not one who was trustworthy in the first place. You gave it to the wrong person. وَنَحْنُ نَقُولُ And we will also say, مَبْتَدَعَ عَالِمٌ قَطْ A scholar never innovates. وَلَكِنَّهُ اسْتُفْتِيَ But the problem is you asked fatwa, you asked a question to مَنْ لَيْسَ بِعَالِمٍ A person who wasn't a scholar. فَضَلَّ وَأَضَلَّ He misguided himself and he misguided you. And that is why Rabi'at al-Ra'i, Rabi'at ibn Abi Abd al-Rahman, Shaykh Imam Malik, he cried one day. Imam Malik said, بَكَى رَبِيعَةُ يَوْمًا رَبِيعَةَ الرَّأِي cried one day. بُكَاءً شَدِيدًا severely. And then it was said to him, أَمُصِيبَةٌ نَزَلَتْ بِكْ Are you afflicted with a severe problem? And then he said, لَا, no. وَلَكِنَّهُ اسْتُفْتِيَ مَنْ لَيْسَ بِعَالِمٍ The reason I am crying is because fatwa was asked by a person who was not of a knowledge. This is Imam Malik's teacher who is saying that fatwa was asked by a person who has no knowledge. That is at the time of Imam Malik. If he was to see this time, what would he have said? Az-Zubayr ibn Adi, rahimahullah, he said, Atayna Anas ibn Malik, we came to Anas ibn Malik. And this was the time of Hajjaj ibn Yusuf al-Thaqafi. Hajjaj ibn Yusuf killed 120,000 people. How many? 120,000 people he killed. So this man was a tyrant individual. So they came to Anas ibn Malik. And they said, Anas, look at what we're going through regarding Hajjaj. And then he said, Isbiru, be patient. فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَأْتِي زَمَانٌ Be patient. He did not say to them, do Arab Spring. Uprise, demonstrate. He didn't say that. He said, Isbiru, be patient. فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَأْتِي زَمَانٌ Because there won't come a time. إِلَّا وَالَّذِي بَعْدَهُ أَشَرُّ مِنْهُ حَتَّى تَلَقُوا رَبَّكُمْ There won't come a time except the one after it is going to be worse. Until you meet your Lord, be patient. This hadith, Ibn Hajar in Fath al-Bari, the 13th volume, page 26 to page 29. Ibn Hajar, rahimahullah, he mentions that this hadith, istashkala ba'adhu al-nas. This hadith, it brought doubts to some people. Because this hadith says that there doesn't come a time except that the time after it is worse. But then this hadith is an ishkal, it's a question to some people. Why? Hajjaj's time was worse than the time of Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, and Umar ibn Abdul Aziz came later. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz came, he came later and Hajjaj was first. But the hadith says there doesn't come a time except the one after it is worse. This ishkal, or this issue, or this misunderstanding, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud explained it. And this is what we want from the khutbah. He says, Ibn Hajar, فَأَخْرَجَ يَعْقُوبُ ابْنَ أَبِي شَيْبَى مِنْ طَرِيقِ الْحَارِثِ ابْنُ حُصَيْرَةِ عَنْ زَيْدِ ابْنُ وَهَبٍ قَالَ سَمِعْتُ عَبْدُلَّهِ ابْنُ مَسْعُودٍ يَقُولُ Abdullah ibn Mas'ud explained this. He said, لَا يَأْتِ عَلَيْكُمْ يَوْمٌ إِلَّا وَهُوَ شَرٌّ مِنَ الْيَوْمِ الَّذِي كَانَ قَبْلَهُ حَتَّى تَقُومَ السَّاعَةُ There will not come a day except that the day after it is worse. that he said, "Lest du'a'ni, I do not mean raha'a min al-'ayshi, that your life is going to be fruitful and you're going to have a nice rainy day and it's going to be a beautiful day. No. وَلَا مَالًا يُفِيدُ, and it is not because you're going to gain money. وَلَاكِ لَا يَأْتِي عَلَيْكُمْ يَوْمٌ, but it means that there won't come a day. إِلَّا وَهُوَ أَقَلُّ عِلْمًا مِنَ الْيَوْمِ الَّذِي قَبْلَهُ, except that the day that comes after it, there is less knowledge. Hajjaj may have been a tyrant leader, and Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, of course, was a just individual, but the time of Hajjaj, there were more Sahaba than the time of Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. There were more Sahaba at the time of Hajjaj than there were at the time of Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. And this is what the hadith is referring to. The goodness of a nation is the existence of the scholars. It means the existence of the scholars. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل واشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل واشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إخواني if the ulama go and the people of knowledge they go ignorance will be seen more and fitan and malahim trials and tribulations will prevail. And you will see that matters will be put in the hand of the wrong people. Matters will be placed in the hands of the wrong people. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in a hadith, Abu Huraira narrated, he said, بَيْنَمَا نَحْنُ بَيْنَمَا النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ فِي مَجْلِسٍ, the Prophet was sitting in a gathering, يُحَدِّثُ الْقَوْمَ, he was talking to the people, جَاءَهُ أَعْرَابِيٌ, a Bedouin came. And the Bedouin said, مَتَ السَّاعَةُ, when will the hour strike, Ya Rasul Allah? فَمَضَى رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, then Prophet carried on talking. The people then amongst themselves said, maybe the Prophet didn't hear what he had to say. Some said, لا, maybe he heard, but he disliked what the man asked. حَتَّى قَضَى حَدِيثَهُ, until the Prophet finished his hadith. When the Prophet ﷺ finished his hadith, he said, أَيْنَ أُرَاهُ السَّائِلُ, where is the one who was asking the question? The one who was asking about the hour, where is he? And then the man goes, Ha ana ya Rasulallah, here I am, O Messenger of Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, the hour will be, فَإِذَا وُضِعَتِ الْأَمَانَةُ فَانْتَظِرِ السَّاعَةِ, if the amana is placed in the wrong hand, wait for the hour. Or if the amana is forsaken. And then the Sahabas, they said, كَيْفَ إِضَاعَتُهَا, how will the amana be forsaken? The Prophet said, إِذَا وُسِّدَ الْأَمْرُ إِلَىٰ غَيْرِ أَهْلِهِ فَانْتَذِرِ السَّاعَةِ, when the matters are placed in the wrong people, then wait for the hour to strike. One of the khilafat, Imam al-Shatibi in his kitab al-I'tisam, Imam al-Shatibi mentions that the disunity that causes the Muslims to divide, and disunity, he mentions three things are the reasons. Three reasons. The first one is تَرْئِيسُ الْجَهَلَ. To make the ignorance leaders. To make the ignorant ones leaders. And that is what he says in his Kitab al-I'tisam. He says, rahimahullah, that this is from the signs of the hour and that the Muslims will be disunited. Is أن يعتقد الإنسان في نفسه أو يعتقد فيه أنه من أهل العلم والاجتهاد في الدين ولم يبلغ تلك الدرجة فيعمل على ذلك أما فيعمل على ذلك وَيُعَدُّ رَأْيُهُ رَأْيًا وَخِلَافُهُ خِلَافًا, that a person thinks of himself, he thinks of himself, or others around him think of him, that he is from the people of knowledge and the people of ijtihad. And then what happens? But he hasn't really reached that. وَلَمْ يَبْلُغْ تِلْكَ الدَّرَجَةً, and he hasn't really reached that level of ilm and rusuq and ijtihad. He hasn't reached it. And then based on that, people start to make him a alim. And they start to implement that thought. And so what do? وَيُعَدُّ رَأْيُهُ رَأْيًا, they start to consider his opinions an opinion. So they'll say, the scholars, they differ in this issue. What scholars? هَذَا لَيْسَ بِعَالِمٍ, he is not a scholar. ويعد خلافه خلافا. And his disagreement with the scholars will be said. The scholars, they differed in this issue or they agreed on it. So this is one of the asbab. And this only occurs when a scholar dies, people start to push another person in the place. People start to push another person in the place. Ikhwani, also what happens is, and that causes, is sins increase in amount and ma'asi and disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, min ashrat as-sa'a, from the signs of the hour, أن يقل العلم, knowledge becomes less. ويظهر الجهل, ignorance becomes more. ويظهر الزنا, ويظهر الزنا, and the zina, it prevails and it shows. وتكثر النساء, and the women, they become more in number. ويقل الرجال, and the men become less. حتى يكون لخمسين امرأة, until 50 women for one man. So here we have zina increasing. Why did the Prophet mention it in the context of knowledge going? Because these sins, they come when the ulama go. And you see, and we live in a time today where things you would think to yourself, subhanAllah, there are people saying it's halal, you're Jews. And this only comes, brothers, when we lose the people of knowledge. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, لَيَكُونَنَّ مِنْ أُمَّتِي أَقْوَامٌ يَسْتَحِلُّونَ الْحِرَى وَالْحَرِيرَ وَالْخَمْرَ وَالْمَعَازِفِ وَلَيَنْزِلَنَّ أَقْوَامٌ إِلَى جَنْبِ عَالَمٍ يَرُوحُ عَلَيْهِمْ بِسَارِحَةٍ لَهُمْ يَأْتِيهِمْ, يعني الفقير, لحاجة فيقول ارجع إلينا غدا فيبيتهم الله ويضع العلم ويمسح آخرين قردة والخنازير إلى يوم القيامة. That they're going to come a time where people make halal for themselves. They will make halal for themselves, zina. يَسْتَحِلُّونَ الْحِرَى وَالْحَرِيرَى. Hira means zina. They will make halal for themselves, zina. And they will say it's permissible. And wallahi, there is now a fatwa that some are saying that zina is haram, but boyfriend and girlfriend is permissible. And as time goes on, the other one starts to come into place. عَجَائِب. And we have people who are pushing in the West that the ulama don't know our waqa. The scholars, they don't know what's the reality that we're living in. The scholars don't understand. So what do they want? They want to place themselves as the scholars and the people of knowledge. And let the people come back to them. وَيُعَدُّ رَأْيُهُمْ رَأْيًا وَخِلَافُهُمْ خِلَافًا نَسْأَلُ اللَّهَ الثَّبَاتَ عَلَى الْحَقِّ وَالْعَزِيمَةَ عَلَى الرُّشْدِ رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا وَإِسْرَافَنَا فِي أَمْرِنَا وَثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَنَا وَانْصُرْنَا عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرِينَ اللَّهُمَّ اغْفِرْ لَنَا هَزْلَنَا وجدنا وخطأنا وعمدنا وكل ذلك عندنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا. رب آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. And we ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to forgive our Shaykh عبد الرحمن بن مرع العدني, who died, and that Allah elevates his status مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا. And every عالم من علماء السنة who died, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resurrect them with the Prophet that they have worked towards his works, and the سلف الصالحين. وأقم الصلاة.